Hello everyone. Today we shall discuss pin description of 8051. The figure shows 8051 pin diagram. 8051 IC is a 40-pin IC and it comes in a dual in package, that is dual inline package, or in short it is called as DIP package. Out of total 40 pins, 32 pins out of that are set aside for 4 ports, that is P0 port, P1 port, P2 port and P3 port. So all the ports P0, P1, P2 and P3 are 8 pins each. The rest of the pins are designated as VCC, ground, extal 1 and extal 2, reset, that is RST, EA bar, that is external access, PSEN, that is program store enable, and ALE, that is address latch enable. So we shall see the pin description of each and every pin. The pin number 40 is a VCC. So that is VCC provides supply voltage to this chip. The voltage source is usually plus 5 volts. Pin number 20 is a GND, that is ground. Pin number 19 and 18 are extal 1 and extal 2, that is crystal oscillator is connected to these two pins, extal 1 and extal 2. So this is the extal connection to the 8051 using a quartz crystal oscillator. We can observe the frequency on the extal 2 pin. So the figure shows the extal connection of 8051. So remember here, the 8051 has an on-chip oscillator, but it requires an external clock to run it. Most oftenly, a quartz crystal is connected to the input pins, that is extal 1, pin number 19, and extal 2, that is pin number 18. The quartz crystal oscillator connected to extal 1 and extal 2 also needs two capacitors of 30 picofarad value. One side of the capacitor is connected to the ground as shown in the figure. So see there, one side of the capacitors are connected to the ground. It must be noted that there are various speeds of 8051 family. So 8051 is not a single IC, it is a family. So speed refers to the maximum oscillator frequency connected to the extal. For example, a 12 MHz chip must connected to a crystal with 12 MHz frequency or less. Likewise, a 20 MHz microcontroller requires a crystal frequency not more than 20 MHz. When the 8051 connected to a crystal oscillator, it is powered up, we can observe the frequency on the crystal 2 pin using the oscilloscope. Pin number 9 is RST, that is reset. So reset, it is an input pin and it is a active high, that is normally low it is. The high pulse must be high at least for 2 machine cycles. Remember here, the high pulse must be high for at least 2 machine cycles. If the crystal frequency is equal to 16 MHz, then find the machine cycle. So if you have a crystal frequency of 16 MHz, then how to find the machine cycle? So remember here, 16 MHz is the frequency given, divided it by 12. So that is equal to 1.33 MHz, that is your crystal frequency. So machine cycle is equal to 1 divided by 1.33 MHz, that is equal to 0.75 microseconds. If the crystal frequency is 11.0592 MHz, remember here, for 8051 microcontroller you need to connect a 11.0592 MHz crystal oscillator. Its frequency is 11.0592 MHz. Then find the machine cycle. So solution for this one is 11.0592 megahertz frequency divided by 12. That is equal to 921.6 kilohertz. So machine cycle equal to 1 divided by 921.6 kilohertz. That is equal to 1.085 microseconds. That means the time required to execute one cycle instruction is 1.085 microseconds. For example, add A comma R1. Add A comma R1. This is the instruction which is of 1 byte. So this instruction executes with in a 1.085 microseconds. So this pin number 9 or RST reset is a power on reset. It is upon applying a high pulse to reset, the microcontroller will reset all the value in register will be lost. So remember here, when the power on reset is applied to this RST pin, the high signal is applied to this pin, it is going to reset all the values in the register. Previously, whatever the register values were loaded, all those are going to be lost. So the reset value of few 8051 registers are given in the table. For example, program counter, its reset value upon the power on reset, its value is going to be 0000. PC is a 16-bit register, its default value is 0000. Even after power on reset, it is going to be 0. Accumulator is 8-bit register, its reset value is 0. B register, 0. PSW is 0. Stack pointer, its default address is 07H. Remember this. It's the default address. DPTR value is also going to be 0. And all the ports upon reset, all the ports are going to be made as input ports. That means the port value P0, P1, P2 and P3 is loaded with value FF. All the RAM values are also going to be 0. So this is the circuit, that is power on reset circuit. So pin number 9 is a reset pin. It is an input and it is an active high. That is, normally it is low. Upon applying a high pulse to this pin, the microcontroller will reset and terminate all the activities. This is often referred as power on reset. This figure shows the RST pin how the power on reset circuitry is. In order for the reset input to be effective, it must be a minimum duration of 2 machine cycles. That means the high pulse must be high for a minimum of 2 machine cycles before it is allowed to go low. Therefore, here is what the Intel says about the reset circuitry is. When power is turned on, the circuit holds the reset pin high for an amount of time that depends on the capacitor value and the rate at which it charges. To ensure a valid reset, the reset pin must be held high long enough to allow the oscillator to start up plus 2 machine cycles. Remember here. Next is a pin number 31, that is A bar pin. A bar is a active low pin and it is called as external access. So in case of 8051, you have internal ROM, but there is no internal ROM in case of 8031 and 8032. The EA bar pin is connected to ground to indicate the code is stored externally. That means whatever the program or whatever the code is there, the program that is going to be stored externally other than the 8051 microcontroller, it is stored somewhere else, that is in the ROM, which is connected externally to this microcontroller. The PSEN, that is program store enable bar, and ALE, that is address latch enable, are also going to be used for external ROM. For this 8051 microcontroller, the EA bar pin is connected to VCC, as we have internal ROM already present in the 8051 IC. The EA bar pin must be connected to VCC. That is, the bar means active low. Next is PSEN bar. That is, pin number 29 is PSEN bar. That is, program store enable. This is an output pin and is connected to the OE pin of the ROM. That is, there is a ROM IC in which there is a pin called as OE pin. So, this is going to be connected to that pin. So, here it is another important signal for the 8051, that is PSEN, which is nothing but a program store enable signal. PSEN is an output signal for the 8051 microcontroller and must be connected to the OE pin of the ROM containing the program code. Suppose if you are storing the program externally, so it is going to be connected, this pin, that is PSEN pin, is going to be connected to the OE pin of the ROM IC. That means to access the external ROM containing the program code, 8051 must use the PSEN signal. If you are connecting an external memory and if you are storing the program in that memory, and then you are going to connect this pin to the OE pin of the ROM. Next pin is ALE. ALE is address latch enable and its pin number is pin number 30. It is an output pin and it is a active high. 8051 port 0 provides both address and data. So, as we have seen the 8051 microcontroller IC chip, the pins port 0, that is P0, provides both address and data. So, the ALE pin is used for demultiplexing the address. So, here the ALE pin is going to be used for demultiplexing purpose. The address bus and the data bus are going to be multiplexed together to save the pins. So, to demultiplex that one, the address and data, by connecting the G pin of the 74LS373 latch. So, since the program counter of the 8051 is 16-bit, it is capable of accessing up to 64 kilobytes of program code. So, in the 8051, port 0 and port 2 provides those 16-bit address to access the external memory of these two ports. P0 provides the lower 8-bit address, that is A0 to A7, and P2 provides the upper 8-bit address, A8 to A15. But P0 is also used to provide the 8-bit data bus, that is G0 to D7. That means pin number P0.0 to P0.7, all these 8 pins are used for both the address and data buses. So, this is called as multiplexing the address and data bus in a chip. So to demultiplex these pins, that is, to either you can use the address bus or data bus at a time to demultiplex this pin, ALE pin is used. That is, when ALE is equal to 0, it uses port 0 for the data bus, and when ALE is equal to 1, it uses the address bus path. So for that purpose, it is going to be connected to the G pin of the 74LS373 latch. The next is IO port pins. So as we know, the 8051 microcontroller has 4 ports, that is P0, P1, P2 and P3. Each port uses 8 pins. So all the IO pins are bidirectional. That means, bidirectional means the data to and from the data can be sent to the microcontroller and from the microcontroller to the external environment. The 8051 has 4 IO ports, that is port 0, pin numbers 32 to 39, that we can use port 0 in a whole, or we can also use port 0 as P0.0 to P0.7. Port 1 is P1, pin number 1 to 8, that is port 1. So you can also access port 1.0 to port 1.7. Similarly, port 2 is pin number 21 to 28, and port 2 can be used as P2.0 to P2.7. So port number 3, pin number 10 to 17, and it can be used as P3.0 to P3.7. So 4 ports, each ports are of 8 pins, and total 32 pins are set aside as IO ports. So each port has 8 pins named as P0.x. X is nothing but 0, 1, 2 up to 7. Similarly, P1.x, P2.x, P3.x. X varies from 0 to 7. P0.0 is the bit 0, that is LSB of port 0, whereas P0.7 is the bit 7, that is MSB, most significant bit of port 0. So remember here, port 0.0 is the least significant bit, and port 0 P0.7 is the most significant bit. Similar to this one, all the ports, port pin 0 is a least significant bit, and higher, most significant bit is port bit 0.7. Each port can be used as input or output, that is bidirectional. So this is the port 0 pull up register. So that is port 0 P0.0 to P0.7 is connected with the pull up register, that is 10k register. There are total 8 10k registers are used, and they are connected as shown in the figure. So as shown in the figure, port 0 is designated as AD0 to AD7, allowing it to be used for both address and data. When connecting to the 8051 to an external memory, port 0 provides both address and data. The 8051 multiplexes address and data through port 0 to save the pins. As there are only 40 pins are available, and you have more than 40 functions to save the number of pins in the 8051 IC. So this is the way to multiplex the different pins. So one single pin is used for multi-purpose, that's why, but at a time only one function can be done. So for multiplexing purpose, this is going to be used. The 8051 multiplexes address and data through port 0 to save the pins. Therefore, ALE indicates if port 0 has the address or data bus here. ALE is the pin that is going to be used, whether it is accessing address or data. When ALE is equal to 0, that means it is accessing or it is providing the data bus D0 to D7. Otherwise, when ALE is equal to 1, it has address A0 to A7. Therefore, ALE is used for demultiplexing the address and data with the help of 74LS373 latch. So this is the purpose of the port 0, where the data bus and address bus is multiplexed. In the 8051 based system, where there is no external memory connection, the pins of port 0 must be connected externally to a 10 kilo ohm pull up resistor. As shown in the figure, a 10 kilo ohm pull up resistor must be connected. This is due to the fact that P0 is an open drain. Unlike port 1, port 2 and port 3, open drain is in term used for metal oxide semiconductor chips, that is MOS chips, in the same way that open collector is used for TTL chips. With the external pull-up resistor connected to P0, it can be used as a simple I/O port, just like P1, P2. That means, in concert to port 0, port 1, port 2 and port 3 do not need any pull-up resistors, since they already have pull-up resistors internally. Upon reset, the port 1, port 2 and port 3 are all going to be configured as input ports. That means, its default value is going to be FF. Only port 0 is going to be connected with the external pull-up resistor, whereas other ports has already the built-in pull-up resistors. This is a port 3 alternate functions. Port 3 has 8 bits, that is P3.0, P3.1 up to P3.7. So its pin number 10 to 17. So functions as shown in the diagram or table: read P3.0 is RxD, P3.1 is TxD, that is receive, transmit. Then P3.2 is INT0 bar, and P3.3 is INT1 bar, that is interrupt 0, interrupt 1. P3.4 and P3.5 is T0 and T1, that is timer 0 and timer 1. And P3.6 and P3.7 are WR bar and RD bar respectively, that is write bar and read bar. So P1, P2 and P3 have internal pull-up resistors. P1, P2 and P3 are not open drain. P0 has no internal pull-up resistors and does not connect to VCC inside the 8051. So P0 is a open drain. So however, for a programmer, it is the same to program P0, P1, P2 and P3. Remember here. So all the ports upon reset are configured as input. It is not output. It is going to be input. Thank you for watching the video.